fantastic. Dominating every facet. Treat the pocket like plastic. Pick on the blitz, pass it. Got it on smash. Put on the gas. I will not crash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash.
It's time for the NFL playoffs on EA Sports, and we are in a city that sure had its share of memorable playoff games in the past. Pittsburgh, PA, and Heinz Field. Today, we continue on in Wild Card Weekend with a great AFC matchup between the Baltimore Ravens and the Pittsburgh Steelers. This will be taken in at the one. And an excellent return there as he's up to the 35 to make it the 40-yard line.
Well, that return gives him a golden opportunity to go out in front. How will the defense respond after giving up that type of a return?
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Room here to run. 20, 10, and he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown. And the defense could not have written a much better script than that first drive, pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They've been a come-from-behind team all year. They'll need to do it again as they trail early in this wild card game. A pretty big opening there on first down. 8 yards up to the 33. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
Brings up second and two at the 33-yard line.
Here's a second and two now from the 33.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home, yo.
Now Rodgers on the bootleg. Man open, it's Goodwin. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Brings up second and 10 at the 50-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. A toss play, Gordon. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great, great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
The Steelers now in the nickel here on third down. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Now Edwards to kick as he sends it away. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
Here we go.
180!
Mike 50. Stop your Wyatt.
Hey, I need one over here. Go!
Now the former fourth-round pick, it's Cannon Balazs, gets this to the 24 for a gain of four.
It's easy work, and it's coming again.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
They'll run here with Balazs. And some room to work. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach, because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to, but they didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Whip. Watch the whip.
Balazs. A gain of three, second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Watch the run.
baby shot, baby. That's a baby shot.
On second and seven, Allen. Oh, Allen cannot get away, and down he goes. Khalil Mack able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time.
We said it before the game, and I think it's still apparent. If these guys are going to advance in these playoffs, they're going to have to wreak some havoc coming off the edge.
Yeah, wild card round. They told us the wild card could be that defensive pressure. They showed it there. So it's third and long, and defensively not a real surprise. They're in the dime. So the shotgun snap to Allen. And that is incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. So that's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Here's Rodgers. And that is incomplete. The intended receiver, Marquise Goodwin, and it's third down.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Got a man, it's Ross, complete. His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
Now Gordon on first down. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 16 yards on that one at a Raven first. They go back to Gordon here on first down. The Pro Bowl corner, Jason Verrett on the tackle.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
From the 44, Rodgers going deep down. This is caught inside the 15. It's a big play there for Baltimore. 47 yards.
But we spent a lot of time exalting the offensive masterminds in this game, right? They draw up these beautiful plays. They look so perfect up on the board. But occasionally, sometimes you just say, throw it up and let him go get it. How about that play?
First red zone chance now for the Ravens. They're looking at a first and goal from about the 9. First and goal, Melvin Gordon. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown run as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. These two teams all tied after one. Second quarter action from Pittsburgh. It is the Steelers in control of the football as they've got it second and seven. On second and seven, Allen. Eluding the pressure right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Off the edge, it's Tyrone Crawford with a sack. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time, when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the run-stuffing variety. But the way this game is advanced, you're wanting a little bit of everything out of all of your guys. But let's just go ahead and break it down and make it simple. The guy who's the right defensive end versus a right-handed quarterback, that's the blind side. He's going after the quarterback. He's going to put him on the ground.
A good pick up there, 26 yards. So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. They run it with Balazs. Trey Kirkpatrick, the cornerback, up to make the stop.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
And the last run got three. Now here's second and seven.
Keep it up, defense. Keep it up, guys.
Now Balazs. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. He lost two there. And it's third down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage.
And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack. Back at the 47-yard line, Khalil Mack able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Here's Logan Cook now as he'll punt it away for the second time. 46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. Good open field tackling there, a 50-yard punt followed by just a 1-yard return. And the Ravens will get it, first and 10 from deep in their own territory. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three. Running right, it's a handoff to Gordon. And he's got Rome. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. A big play there by Gordon. Give him 58 yards on the ground. So how about this for a change in field position? From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. Deep ball for Goodwin. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. A big seam, and he might go all the way. And he's in for six and a Steeler touchdown. So from one end zone all the way to the other. Talk about a turnaround.
And how about the excitement that that play generates for his team? Not just the points on the board, but the momentum and taking it from coast to coast, end zone to end zone. What a tremendous play. Now get that man an oxygen tent.
That's your boy Old Mo, you said momentum, right?
Old Mo, I think he's kind of limping across at the end because of that distance, but he made it.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
They told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Give the tackle there to Danielle Hunter. Looking to throw on second down. Rodgers. Open man is Ross, complete. Yeah, he's got to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A gain there of 21 yards. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Working from the gun. Rodgers. Got a man open. It's Ross. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. The Ravens get a new set of downs, give him 17 on that pickup. And the Ravens first down. 2 minutes to play here in this first half of the NFL playoffs. A reminder coming up at the half, as we've done all year. We'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin on the road to Super. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. It's the linebacker, Alex Anzalone. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So that is three interceptions now in this first half, and you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest, we're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here, but he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
Now they try the right side here. And some room to run now. The 40, past the 20, 10, and into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Kalen Ballage, 97 yards. And the Steelers get the quick strike touchdown. Extra point through the snowflakes, up and good. And it's now 21-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness, maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Running left, it's Gorge on the toss. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. On play action, now Rodgers. Seferian Jenkins has it. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Here's Lachlan Edwards now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. You've got under a minute to go here until halftime. You got the good size lead. No need to do anything crazy.
No, there really is no need to do anything crazy. The smart play, go ahead and take your lead into the locker room and then try and add to it in the second half. But there's a part of me that looks at this and says, first half going my way. I have a little bit of a cushion.
And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. Khalil Mack able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon. Now the Steelers use the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. They come up on second and long, and the pass protection just has not been there this afternoon. Now Allen. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. The Steelers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and forever.
Go, go.
From the gun, it's Allen. He's going to sling this deep downfield. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Alabama man, Dre Kirkpatrick. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
A little over 20 seconds remaining in the half as they'll line up here first and 10.
Mike 55.
Exit. A little flare.
Go to 50. Hey, you block over here. Run.
Check.
26.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The sack by Ronald Darby coming from the corner. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. So we're at halftime of this AFC wild card matchup as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams try to avoid being one and done in these playoffs as we start the second half of this AFC wild card game.
That's it, baby. We gonna work.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. A big run there, 29 yards and a first. One thing that's great about watching him run, Charles, he doesn't hesitate. He got to the left side of his O-line and just went.
So there's two ways to look at that. One, just absolutely unconcerned, just takes off and goes. But more the latter, I think, which is he has absolute confidence in the guys in front of him, the guys doing the blocking for him. He just takes it and goes with abandon.
Right back to him on first down. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 12 yards that time at a Pittsburgh first.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Now a handoff looking right. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Escaping the pressure right.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
The Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Alabama man, Dre Kirkpatrick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They'll start on the ground. This is Gordon on first down. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. They'll try and run it. Here's Gordon. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. Now Rodgers. And it is incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of 3.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. They get the first. The decision to run on third and medium winds up being a good one. Allen now on the sneak. Pushing and fighting his way in for a Steeler touchdown. Josh Allen keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Steelers, they broaden their lead. Boswell good with the extra point. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
How many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. They run it here with Gordon. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40 and all the way down to the 33-yard line. Add the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Another tote for Gordon. He's been busy this afternoon. Works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of 4.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
From the 29, Rodgers looking for the end zone. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down.
You know they wanted, you know they expected. They needed him to be sharp coming out after the half. Unfortunately, he's missed his first 3 throws. I wonder if he got out late and missed his warm-up time.
The whole team did come out a little bit later than usual. I don't know, maybe there's something to that.
Must have been a heck of a halftime speech.
Yeah, maybe just trying to rally the troops back from this deficit.
Check it back.
On on third down. This is Melvin Gordon. And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. Rodgers to throw for it on fourth. He's going to have the hook up to Ross. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 10 yards there, good enough for a Raven first down.
Well, the field goal attempt was well in hand. They had that, but they decided to go for it anyway. Extreme confidence, it looks like.
Yeah, but I bet the defense is going to remember this one, right? They kind of rubbed their nose in it. On first down, Gordon. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be second and 12. To throw, it's Rodgers. Flush to his right. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number three. This will be the eighth play of the drive here. Third and four. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And that's knocked away and incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
They run. Devontae Freeman. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. They opt to go for it, and they get it. First and goal after a pickup of 5. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. Second and goal from inside the 5. Now a play fake. Rodgers. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line.
Remember throughout my career here in defensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. And they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. A great job to hold him to just a yard there. Now it's fourth and goal. A field goal does you no good, so they're going to stay out there and go for it on fourth. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The drive will commence with a run by Balazs. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they won't put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the 1-yard pickup. Sets up third and 6.
I think if we put together a job description for a middle linebacker, we would start with being able to hold down things in the middle of the line of scrimmage and be able to take on blockers. But how about the guys who can go sideline to sideline and make plays?
Love a guy that can do that. We saw a perfect example of it right there. Allen gonna throw. Going deep here for Watkins. Incomplete. Both players were there offensively and defensively, but it falls incomplete. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
Very good return that time. 18 yards. And the Ravens, they'll take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Quan Alexander. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
Again, it's Ballage. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 22 yards there, a first down.
I've got an idea. Let's skip racing to the airport at the end of this game. Let's go to the post-game press conference. I have a feeling that the quarterback of this winning team is going to be giving a whole lot of credit to the running game and the offensive line.
Yeah, I was just going to say the offensive line. Yes, carrying the ball has been key, but those guys up front, they've made a lot of space. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Big Geno Atkins here to bring him down. And the Steelers on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This is third and 10. Allen operating from the gun. He's going to loft one deep left side and into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Tyreek Hill, 48 yards. And the Steelers, they broaden their lead. Extra point put through by Boswell, and that'll increase their lead to 28. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken at the 3.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them.
Let's put that team on the bus.
And they take a knee.
Rodgers on the keeper. It's a loss of a yard. Brings up second and 11 at the 16-yard line.
And Charles, on the losing side of things, you know, they didn't come in here as the favorite to these playoffs, but they came in with a lot of hope and anticipation. Tough to have that all snuffed out so quickly.
It really is. You're one of 12 teams when the playoffs begin that still has a chance to win the Super Bowl. So that's pretty darn good. And as you often talk about, a lot of hope when the playoffs start. Well, that ended for them. But when they look back, they'll have a lot to be proud of and see if they turn the page towards the next season.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. The Steelers are winners as we say so long from Heinz Field.